Hey guys! A week ago, I've uploaded a sort of a farewell patch to the Geodesics module series I've concluded recently, and I was really happy to know that some of you asked for a patch breakdown video. So in this video, I will show you how I've built the patch, which modules I chose to use, and how everything is patched together. Let's start! Okay, so there will be a link in the description to this patch. I recommend you go ahead and download it so we can look at it together. I've divided the patch into 6 sections. We have the clock section, which includes also brains in this case. We have the mixer section with the dual delay and plateau. And then we have a section for each voice. And let's start with the first voice that's coming from these 2 FM operators. Ions is receiving a clock from the main clock to its global input, and its probability knob is set to around 80%, so almost each time the yellow or blue ions reach the end of their sequence, they jump to the other sequence and output different CV amounts. Both of Ions' CV outputs are going to Erwin from AppleSense modules, which is set to a certain scale, and from there the voltage goes to both FM operators. Now, each time the blue and yellow ions jump to the other sequence, a trigger is being fired out of the respective trigger outputs, and this is triggering the FM operators. Because of this, the CV amount that goes through will always be the same because they are triggered just on the first step, but after about 2 minutes into the patch, I activate the quantum leap mode, which means that the ions can switch sequences at each and every step, so there are more triggers and therefore more notes being played. The feedback amount of both FM operators is being modulated by both white noise based sample and hold outputs of brains. Now, before we listen to how this sounds like, let's take a short look at the dual delay, because it's being quite heavily modulated. Brains is receiving 2 different clocks from the main clock, and it's modulating the time, the feedback amount, and the low pass and high pass settings of both sections of the dual delay, what adds a lot of variation and movement to the sound. Let's take a listen to how it sounds like, and try to listen also to the delay and how it adds notes in unpredictable places, and I will also activate the quantum leap mode so we can hear the differences. So you could hear how in the beginning of the patch there are less notes, but then to add more excitement I activated the quantum leap mode and there were more things happening. The second voice is coming from another FM operator. We have also black holes and pulsars. Black holes is sending constant voltage to 7 inputs of the upper pulsar, and from there it's going back to black holes in order to slightly attenuate the signal. Now, the wormhole function of black holes is activated, which means that the mixed signal from the upper black hole is coming out of the outputs of the lower black hole. From there, the signal goes through a chain of modules. It's going to quantum from ML, to the pitch tools module from 21 kHz, to the slew limiter from Befaco, and then to slope from triggerfish to the volt per octave input of the FM operator. Quantum is set to the same scale as Erwin, and the pitch tools modules is inverting the signal every time it receives a gate from the first LFO in this section. The slew limiter adds a glide or portamento between the notes, and slope is adding this human feel to the sound by introducing drift to the pitch. The second LFO in this section drives pulsars, which is in supernova mode, so it's scanning and morphing randomly between the different signals, and the LFO is also modulating the feedback amount of the FM operator. Let's listen to this voice and then add also the sequence we heard before and try to listen to the pitch of this voice and how it's going in and out of tune. Okay, the next voice is coming from two more FM operators and another ions. This time, ions is receiving two different clocks to both of its local clock inputs, so the yellow and blue ions run in a different rate, and its probability knob is all the way up, so we get two 16-step sequences. Both CV outputs go again through Erwin, and then they are split up, once to the volt per octave inputs of the FM operators, and once to the CV to trigger module, also from AppleSense. The trigger to CV module turns the voltage coming out of ions to triggers, and this is triggering both FM operators. You can see that this time I sent both oscillators to two mono channels and not one stereo channel, although they are hard pan left and right, because I wanted to control their volume separately. Let's listen to this and add also the other voices. The last voice is coming from the Chebyshev oscillator. We have the 8FO from Bog Audio, outputting 8 waves to the upper pulsar, which is in supernova mode, to the envelope generator input of Chebyshev. A sine wave from this LFO is driving this pulsar, which morphs randomly between the different signals. When nothing is connected to the input of the lower pulsar, the signals from the upper part come out of the lower part's outputs, and these signals modulate the different harmonics of Chebyshev. I also play with the tune knob of Chebyshev, lowering its pitch by 7 semitones at certain times, and I also play with the knobs of the upper ions to get variation in notes, and with the octaves of Erwin to change the register of the notes. This voice is not going through the dual delay, but rather directly to the reverb, and if we look for a second at the reverb, I have the modulation depth at around 12 o'clock, what helps even more in creating an organic, full of movement sound. Let's listen to this voice and add all the rest, and I will also play with the tune knob of Chebyshev, and try to listen also to the modulation coming from the reverb. Thank you. And that's it, guys. Like I said, there will be a link in the description to this patch and also to the Geodesics module series. If you find it interesting, feel free to check it out. And I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please hit the like button. If you want to see more videos like this, please subscribe and hit the bell. And have a good one.